What would the world of desserts be without the delicate flavor of vanilla? Almost one-third of the world's ice cream eaters pick vanilla as their first choice, me included. But this beloved flavor's history is anything but, vanilla. How did it become the default flavor for some of the world's best-loved desserts? Why is vanilla so expensive? Who first used vanilla as a flavoring? A. Thomas Jefferson? B. The Aztecs? C. The Totonac? Or D. Edmund Albius? Stay with us as we sniff out the answer to that and a lot more. Vanilla planifolia orchids produce vanilla beans. Native Totonac people first found it growing in the Mesoamerican areas we now call Mexico and Guatemala. Vanilla has been put to some interesting uses throughout history, ranging from an aphrodisiac to cures for male impotence and snake bites. Kind of an all-around cure. But once humans savored its intoxicating sweetness, we were hooked. But at 350 euros per kilogram, vanilla beans are the second most expensive ingredient in the world. And that's why 99% of the vanilla-flavored products you consume get made with artificially prepared vanillin, not vanilla beans from orchids. So why is real vanilla so expensive? Vanilla beans are one of the most exacting crops to cultivate. It takes 2.26 to 3.2 kilograms of green vanilla beans to produce 0.45 kilograms of processed vanilla. The flowers must get pollinated by hand during the 24 hours that they bloom. Expert farmers develop a sixth sense for knowing when the flowers are about to bloom. Successful pollination yields a 15 to 25 centimeter pod with thousands of tiny seeds inside it. The pods take 9 months to ripen and need hand picking. The curing process that follows is equally painstaking. The beans get sorted, grated, and put in hot water to stop fermentation. Then they spend 2 weeks drying in the sunlight and sweating through the nights. Next comes 30 days of slowly drying the beans indoors before they're ready to be packed and transported for sale. This is a complex cultivation and curing process, and only about 2,000 metric tons of vanilla beans get harvested each year. But vanilla was not always this hard to cultivate. In their native Mexico, bees and hummingbirds pollinate the orchids. When the Spanish brought vanilla to Europe at the turn of the 16th century, the plants refused to adapt to new pollinators. Botanists were in a bind. It wasn't until 1841 when horticulturist Edmund Albius succeeded in hand-pollinating a vanilla plant on the Réunion Islands with a blade of grass and a swipe of his thumb. Albius had been born into slavery and was only 12 years old at the time. He had learned about botany from the plantation's owner, Ferriol Bellier Beaumont. Albius studied the vanilla plant and found its reproductive parts. He dusted the stigma into the pollen, which was separated by a flap. Beaumont had been pampering his vanilla plant for 22 years at this point, and Albius's efforts made it fruit for the first time. Beaumont immediately sent Albius to train other plantation workers in the intricate art. Over the next 50 years, vanilla cast a spell on the people of Europe. Réunion Island became a major vanilla exporter, producing nearly 200 tons. But without the genius of this 12-year-old enslaved botanist, vanilla would likely have remained a rare and exotic ingredient. Sadly, Albius never received credit for his work during his lifetime. Freed in 1848, he died in poverty. A 1900 journal article is the only record that acknowledges Albius as a black man of incredible genius. Albius's technique of pollinating the vanilla plant is still used today. But how did this magical herb go from aphrodisiac to flavoring everything from cookies to soup? Albius's efforts widened the reach of this delicious aromatic bean, but using it as a flavoring was not his idea. The American minister to France, Thomas Jefferson, popularized vanilla as an ice cream flavor, although he didn't invent it. The Totonac Indians only used it for medicinal purposes until the 15th century. When the Aztecs defeated the Totonac, they got their hands on some vanilla beans and began experimenting. So if you guessed the Aztecs first used vanilla as a flavoring, you're right. They mixed it with other delicious ingredients, like cacao. And thus was born the vanilla chocolate swirl. But which ingredient is even more expensive than vanilla? We have that covered in another episode of Origins of Food. Don't you love how we just keep it rolling?